Nobody's heard from me for months. I'm doing better than I ever was.
I'm very busy.
Well, I'm sure you are.
I don't like your tone.
I'm sure you are.
There's no way I'm autistic. Sarcasm is like a second language to me.
That's a really colorful outfit you're wearing.
Aw, thank you. I really love picking out colorful clothes.
So what did you do this weekend?
I went to a fleece convention and it was so much fun. There were booths full of colorful yarn everywhere and there were sheep that we got to pet. It was such a blast.
Cool.
I know, it was so much fun.
Hey, are you almost done getting ready? I need to use the bathroom soon.
Yeah, I'm almost done. I was just gonna do my hair real fast. Do you need it right now?
Nope. Take your time.
Okay, thanks. I'll be out whenever I'm done.
Ugh, you're such a dumbass sometimes.
Okay, your tone is sarcastic, so I know that you're being sarcastic, but what if your sarcasm is rooted in truth, and you actually do think I'm a dumbass? What have I done recently that would get me labeled as a dumbass?
Hey, can I use your restroom?
Absolutely not.
Wait, are you being serious?
No, I'm not being serious. Why would you think you weren't allowed to use my restroom?
I don't know. It seems a little unreasonable, but it's your house and your boundaries, so I didn't want to disrespect them.
You can catch me in Vegas, catch me in Tokyo, catch me on a dick trying to ride like a rodeo.
Yeah!
I'm a riding hood. You can eat me like a middle red riding hood.
Yo, I'm a kid with the ass.
I've had chicken fingers for breakfast. I've had chicken fingers for lunch. I've had chicken fingers for dinner. I feel like a chicken finger.
So I was recently hanging out with a friend from high school, and we ended up going over to his grandparents' house. And when we got there, you could hear this, like, 8-year-old boy screaming in the background, not having a good day. And the grandma comes up to me, she's apologizing, she's like, I'm sorry, he's autistic, and he's just having a really rough day right now. And at first I didn't know how to respond exactly, because, like, I'm also autistic. Do I share this information to make him more comfortable that I'm here, or do I keep it to myself? So eventually we're all sitting on the couch, we're chatting, and grandma's talking a little bit about his autism and whatnot. And then eventually I casually bring up the fact that I'm also autistic, and I can definitely empathize and relate to a lot of the struggles. Like, I have those bad days too, and they don't have to worry about making me feel comfortable or whatever it is, because they seemed a little bit wary at first. And I was really nervous about what the reaction would be, because it could have so easily been, well, you're not autistic like him, so you can't possibly understand, or, well, he has severe autism and you clearly don't, or something that just kind of feels really icky and harmful. My friend's grandma had the sweetest reaction. Grandma's like, oh really? It's crazy. People don't realize how common autism actually is. You know, sometimes I question whether or not my son's autistic, because seeing his kid and his autism, I see a lot of similarities between them. She asked me when I was diagnosed, and I told her that I kind of figured out I was autistic around 18, 19, but got diagnosed at 20. And she was like, I can't imagine how much of a relief that must have been. Like, so many things in your life probably just started making sense. And I was like, yeah, it definitely answered a lot of questions I had about my childhood and growing up. And then she was like, well, I'm really glad you finally got those answers. And then we just continued on talking, conversation as normal. It was like a non-issue. And this is also the first time that my high school friend heard me say I was autistic. So I was really worried that he would have some type of reaction or say something like when we left or bring it up. But nope, it like didn't affect anything whatsoever. Everything was the same. Like, it wasn't even brought up. And yeah, it was a really good experience of telling someone you're autistic.
And here we go. I hope you're hungry for nothing.
I'm all out of home. One more bad break.
That reminds me of this one time in middle school when these girls were basically just like laughing at how
Oh my God, they were bullying me. So anyway.
Hi everyone, welcome to my new series where I rate autism t-shirts. First runner-up is... God found some of the strongest women and unleashed them to be autism moms. Unleashed them. And also indicating that you need to be somehow strong to raise an autistic person. Next. Every day, I'm puzzling. I don't think it could get worse than this. Autism. It's not a disability. It's a different ability. But it is a disability, though. And this is for a child. Okay, moving on. Mama Bear. We have a polar bear with a puzzle piece polar bear cub. Oh my God. Autism is my superpower. And then we have some sort of Captain America sword with a puzzle piece dang smack in the middle. Okay, guys, late though. Always unique, totally intelligent, sometimes mysterious. Yes, I am autistic. Stare if you must. I'm not paying attention to you anyway. I just realized I didn't rate any of those, but they're all 0 out of 10. All of them fit. These were so bad.
I have no idea what I'm doing, but I know I'm doing it really, really well.